Hey, welcome back to another build video. We're keeping it simple this time. This is the fishing shack from Bar Mills Models. Let's see what's in the box. Some plastic doors and windows. This is a pretty modest kit, but my layout has a pond swamp area, and I think that this would be a good fit for it. It doesn't exist yet, and I was planning on making a video of making the pond and the swamp. And in fact, by the time you're watching this, that video might even exist, and maybe you've even seen it before. Since I don't know when you're watching this video. I actually already messed up. On these pieces with the shingle siding, you're supposed to put the shingle siding on before you attach these trim pieces. And I actually attached the trim pieces before I put on the shingle siding. It's easy enough to just cut them off and then put the siding on. So this shingle siding is easy enough to apply. It just is paper with a sticky backing and you just peel off the strips and stick them on, and then for the doors and windows, you can just cut them out afterwards. I'm ready to start assembling the walls with the siding, and I took a chance that I knew what I was doing, and I added some braces here on these two end pieces so that I have a little more gluing surface for the walls to come together. These walls are actually cardboard, they're not wood. These other walls, the clapboard walls, those are wood. One part that was a little confusing in the instructions is on these two pieces, when they come together, it doesn't look like there's any trim that goes on. The instructions don't mention trim for these walls, but in the cover photo, it sort of looks like there is a piece of trim down here. So I don't know whether they're supposed to be trim or not supposed to be trim there. So I'll find out when I get closer to assembling them. I have this part assembled, and for this part, I sprayed it with a gray enamel spray paint to prevent warping when I put the acrylic paint on. And I just want to test fit to make sure that these are going to go on with the roof at the right angle. It looks like it's a really tight fit. These are the roof sections, and this is the roofing paper, which you just apply because it sticks. The roof sections have lines scribed on them to show where the roofing paper goes. So I think it's just as straightforward as pulling it off and sticking it on. Here's where I am with the assembly, getting it together, and I'm working on the floor. And this piece, it's not entirely obvious, but this center piece needs to be cut out and saved because it is going to support the deck. So here's the deck, and it goes on top like that, I believe. Also, this piece has paper covering a sticky side, so you pull the paper off and then you attach this on top of that, nicely centered. So you have to center this because it's not the exact same size. So with the edges approximately centered, the center hole actually is not very centered, so I don't think it matters. This is where I am with construction. I have pretty much everything except the windows and the supports done. And now it's time to do some weathering. So I'm going to do a wash of the folk art barn wood. So I'm not going to do this wash on the blue walls, because I kind of like them the way they are. But this shingle siding needs a little bit of aging. The deck was painted with the Vallejo transparent wood grain color. I'm working on my doors and windows, and I painted them Vallejo stone gray, and then I gave them a wash of Vallejo gray, and I let that dry. And now I'm going to do some dry brushing. Now, I don't do a lot of dry brushing on these models. Back when I started doing models, dry brushing was a real common technique, but people don't seem to use it as much anymore. Washes and dry brushing were about the only thing that we had. When I was a kid, we didn't even have weathering powders. So what I do is I take my gray and I mix it with a little bit of white, and then I get most of the paint off of the brush like that, and then I run it over the piece, and that paint just hits the highlights. One of the reasons I don't do it much is it seems to destroy the brushes, because you basically have a lot of acrylic paint drying onto the brush, and it can be hard to get out, and over time it just eventually destroys the brush faster than not doing it. So back in the 70s and 80s, the modeler Francois Verlinden, he was sort of the big modeler of the time. He did a lot of military models, and I was into military models back then. And his big thing was he had a really specialized dry brush technique that made a really cool look. Now, it wasn't necessarily realistic. You may not say it was realistic, but it looked really cool, and a lot of people tried to imitate it. You would start with the base color and you would lighten it a little bit. And then once that dried, which doesn't take long, you come back with the base color and lighten it even more and use less paint. So now I might mix in a lot more white and get a lighter color and really get almost all of it out of the brush. And then come back and hit the pieces again. So you'll see what this looks like in the close-ups. So a lot of my builds that I've been doing for the videos and stuff for my layout, they're really weathered to death. My layout really has an abandoned, decrepit theme. But if I were to build one of these buildings and have it look new, I would do a lot more dry brushing and a lot less of the weathering powders and the washes and things like that, and the chip paint. And here's the roof of my shack, and I put that gray wash on, and it was the folk art. So it's a little bit, you know, it's that cheap paint, and it doesn't really go on really well. So I'm just going to see what happens if I do some dry brushing on here, because this is going to be really easy to paint over if I don't like the look. In this case, it's not exactly the same shade of gray. But you can see how all the nail holes that were in the paper are now much more visible. If you get too white, it'll end up looking like your model was in a snowstorm or something. So one tip is to clean out the brush at this point. Use rubbing alcohol instead of water. It does a much better job of dissolving the acrylics. I wasn't really happy with the way it was looking, so I gave it a black wash, actually Vallejo dark gray, on the shingles and on the roof, but not on the blue part, because I like the way the blue part looks. And I think I'm going to put some weathering powders on the roof. I was going to try and build this thing without weathering powders, because you know I love those things. But I'm going to give in here and put them on the roof at least. This is the structure after I've applied the weathering powders, and then I sprayed it with some Tamiya flat clear. I think the roof looks better. I'm pretty happy with everything. I installed their doors and windows and added the shutters. So it's coming along nicely. Next thing I need to do is to put in the support posts. So there's 6 support posts. And fortunately, they actually give you 6 sticks. And I think these are bamboo. And I'm going to chop them on the chopper here, and I'm going to set it for about an inch. I don't know, maybe it's over an inch and a half. Too long is much better than too short, so I guess I'll go for an inch and a half. The foam that of my layout is an inch and a half thick, so I can't imagine that that's not going to be sufficient to get it up to the top of the pond. sheet has some pieces here. This is where the shutters were. I have no idea what these pieces are. One of the weird things about the instructions is the only picture for the whole kit, I think, is this one. But you do get these line drawings. So this is supposed to be rungs for the ladder, and then here is the ladder. So I'm not sure how these are supposed to go together. Maybe like that.